What?
Boy, I don't think they're ready for this.
These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. Put up on them and it look nice. Look nice. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future.
Yeah, we look nice, future looking nice, we don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
Yeah, we look nice, future looking real nice, we don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
Western Sydney Wanderers hoping to break their season duck with the comfort of home surrounds. Can they find the back of the net as they welcome Newcastle Jets for round three of Liberty A-League Women's Action? Lots of youngsters and, well, older fans as well making the most of an early Friday afternoon kickoff. Beautiful weather, warm sunlight, and look at that, some Blacktown Spartans players representing the local area getting out to watch their Wanderers. And they'll be hoping to cheer on the home team as they take on a Newcastle Jets team that was in fine form against the Wellington Phoenix, dispatching them last weekend. Hasn't quite been the same situation for Western Sydney, though, and as I welcome former Matilda Grace Gill to the commentary booth. Grace, it has been the burning question, where are the goals going to come from for Western Sydney, and can they break through today?
Oh, well, thanks, Taylor. It's a pleasure to be here, and it's a really good question. We've seen the likes of Briley Henry come into the side for the Wanderers, and the attacking prowess that she brings will be really important.
A couple of outs for Western Sydney, Isabella Habuda and also Bianca Galich were starting 11 last week, but they drop out due to injury today, and it means we see on the bench for the first time this season Ashley Crofts and Sarah Morgan. For the Newcastle Jets, Tiana Jaber is back from suspension due to being a close contact. Marie Dolvik is out, the Norwegian international. No Kirsty Fenton either, also due to the COVID situation that is afflicting both the Newcastle men's and women's teams. If we see Josie Morley today, it will be a debut for the 18-year-old.
It's incredibly important for the Wanderers to start really strong this evening and really send a statement to the Jets.
So, Briley Henry, you can see how heavily that left knee is strapped. It had confined her to the bench in the first two weekends of A-League Women's Action. She has only scored just the two goals in just the one game. I'm sure she would love to score in her home state in front of her home fans. And there is Tara Andrews. One goal today and she would draw level with the two all-time leading scorers in the Matildas, Lisa Devanna and Kate Gill. 41 A-League women's goals to her name. She is by far the Jets' all-time leading scorer. And she has two Matildas caps of her own, so she can draw level with a couple of our greats today. Tegan Collister is a former Newcastle player. They gave her her start in A-League women's. But now we're ready to go. Good crowd getting into the intimate surrounds of the Wanderers Football Academy, and Western Sydney will be attacking the left of your screens as we get round three of Liberty A-League underway. And Sheridan Gallagher will kick us off here with Libby Copas-Brown. And so Western Sydney Wanderers get us underway on Friday afternoon. And Grace Gill, I'm going to ask you for a tip. Who's going to win and why?
Way to put the pressure on there, Teo. Look, I think the Newcastle Jets are coming off the back of a really big statement last week. To get a 5-1 result is just seriously dominant. Equally, though, Western Sydney Wanderers looking for their first win, looking for that first result. I think the Jets are going to edge them out just because the likes of Emily Van Egmond and the strings that she can pull, and even players like Elizabeth Eddy, she's just such a great inclusion in this Jets side, and she's a real live wire.
Caitlin Cooper is going to usher the ball, and even though it's a very firm and good pitch, it just ran out of juice there, and it necessitates a back pass to Sarah Langman, who clears the lines, and Liz Eddy, the 30-year-old American, will take the throw in. There is Sarah Langman, the Wanderers keeper. Look at that, bit of loose checking leaves Tara Andrews loose at the top of the box, but she went for the pass rather than the shot. The ball bounces over Sheridan Gallagher, and Hannah Bruin nods in for her first touch. And now the other centre-back for Wanderers, Claire Hunt, gets the ball back to Willisey. Certainly not a lot of distance on the clearance. Tegan Collister up against Lucy Johnson. A couple of errant touches in there, and persistence here from Collister against Eddie. Neither of them taking a backward step, and it is the Australian winger who prevails initially, but Eddie did not give up. Ooh, and a foul is given right at the last there. And so Eddie concedes the first free kick of the game.
Look, I think that's shaping up to be a really good battle straight from the outset. Eddie up against Collister, both pretty sprightly players, pretty rapid. So I'm really interested to see how that one plays out this evening in the sort of afternoon sun as well.
So long range free kick here. Libby Kofus-Brown is pointing towards the penalty spot and roosts it to the edge of the area. Briley Henry in for the header and Taryn King slices it behind for the first corner of the game. And this could be a set-piece opportunity for Wanderers to break through, and Kofus-Brown will run over to take the corner. There's Sheridan Gallagher. Only made her debut in round one, now starting her third straight game. And so you can see Kofus-Brown here absolutely ran herself into the ground against Sydney FC without much in terms of support or reward last week. Actually cramped up in stoppage time and had to come off, so referee here is just going to go and do the mandatory calm down talk. Let's not forget it's only game two for Newcastle keeper Georgia Borich as she continues to hold the gloves ahead of Claire Coelho. And so after a bit of build-up, here comes the corner from Kofus-Brown. It's over the keeper's head and the net was open. Far from convincing, but Claire Hunt could not keep the header down.
That's a really quality ball in there from Kofus-Brown, putting it into a really dangerous part of the six-yard box there. And good start there for the Wanderers too. And just interesting, Tao, I've noticed it looks as though Ash Brodigan for the Jets has actually started on the field and Lauren Allen, so there's been a swap there and Lauren Allen's taken the bench. So interesting whether that's a tactical change or otherwise. We thought Lauren Allen had gotten a first start for the evening.
So Newcastle, maybe something's happened in the warm-ups to necessitate that swap for Ash Wilson, the Jets coach. That was out of bounds, which means we can throw down for the first time today at pitch level to Russ Gibbs. Russ, hello.
Both coaches have been very vocal in the early stages and the late change. Lauren Allen has taken her place on the bench in full kit and looks sprightly in doing so. So my guess is that might well have been a late tactical switch.
Thanks, Russ. And that's good to hear because Lauren Allen has been... She scored a goal and had an assist in her two appearances as a super sub this year. So maybe the team sheet just got punched into the machine incorrectly, Grace, and they want to keep her for later on in the second half on a warm day.
Yeah, I was going to mention Lauren Allen. She's been particularly effective off the bench, and you mentioned her goal and the assist.
And this is where it's breaking down. Edge of the defensive third. Wanderers cannot hit up a pass in midfield at the moment.
Yeah, you can see as well the Jets are almost allowing the Wanderers to play that first pass out of pressure from Langman in the goal there, and then applying pressure on the second ball. And Wanderers are really struggling to deal with that and to break that press, and they... losing possession time and time again, but there's a little bit of a late challenge from Hannah Brewer and picks up a yellow card for her efforts.
Well, that's really a circuit breaker that Wanderers needed. Halloway may have bore the brunt of that challenge, but Brewer goes in the book and goes in the book early.
Yeah, that is an early card to pick up. I think it's the right call there. It's a bit of a reckless foot that's been left in and a right call, but what it means now for Hannah Brewer is that she's got to be on her best behaviour for the next 60 minutes, 70 minutes of this game to see out the full match.
So, Brewer, very experienced player. Oh, asthma attack. That's not good here for Libby Kofus-Brown. Catherine Cannulli, the Wanderers coach, is right there. Hopefully she doesn't have to leave the game, but obviously her well-being is first and foremost here. She doesn't look too distressed. I guess if you're an athlete with asthma, you know the drill in this situation.
Yes, certainly. I think whether it's an asthma attack or just trying to get her breathing under control on what's a really warm afternoon, just important for Kofus-Brown to take a moment and settle her heart rate there. I do hope she's okay and able to continue.
So that means that Western Sydney are temporarily down to 10, but it may not matter here if Collister can get this pass right. Gallagher stepped over. The follow-up is wide. And Wanderers, well, their best chance of the game, but Halloway did not have the finishing touch.
That is a fantastic opportunity for the Wanderers there to get their first goal and find that in the back of the net. Tegan Collister, that's a really great ball across the six-yard box, but the defensive effort there from Tiana Jabe just to put enough pressure on Halloway, send her shot wide, is an incredibly important defensive intervention, and what a good opportunity for the Wanderers.
Well, they may feel they should be 1-0 up here. Incredibly, they would have scored down to 10 players. King, and now Brewer. Skim headed by Andrews. Franco knew where the ball was going, but so did Matos. And Danica Matos clears it out. You can see possession is pretty much level. And Johnson twisting it back. Davis has never scored in A-League Women's. It might be game 100, but she'd love to mark it with the gold. Jabe has never scored either until now. To score for the first time in the National League.
What a strike there from Tiana Deva. She just found herself in a little bit of space, a good solid first touch to set herself up. And have we look here on the Harvey Norman replay, she's just seen Sarah Langman just off her line, and what a strike. Sarah Langman unable to get an outstretched arm to that, but returning to the Jets side, Tiana Deva, a top finish, and the Jets are off and flying.
I'm not sure the trajectory dipped. That was a bullet from Tiana Jaber. And she has been all action, got sent off in round one, and announces her return from suspension with a contender for goal of the season. And in what is only game six for her, the former Wanderer, would you believe, played one solitary game for Western Sydney a couple of seasons ago, has come back to haunt her former club. You didn't want her, and now she's on the score sheet.
And what a way to mark your return to the A-League Women's after that suspension, serving that one-match ban. What a statement piece that goal was.
And now Wanderers with Copus Brown back on the pitch, which is great news. We'll get a bit of an insight when we can at the next break in play. As Collister keeps the ball in, the duel with Eddie continues. Lizetti prevails here, tangle of legs and a free kick. And as the whistle goes on that free kick, let's just go back down to Russ Gibbs on the sidelines.
Yeah, Copus Brown was complaining that she couldn't breathe, which was quite worrying for everybody connected with the Wanderers, but she came off, got a few puffs on the asthma pump and some water, and she seems to be in no problems at the moment and carrying on.
From the centre of defence, Price and Hunt, a quick one too. Game still feels in the balance. Newcastle have had certainly some strong phases, but Wanderers, they look closer to scoring today than they have in their previous two games. Case in point right here, a bit of panic, a bit of nerves, albeit short-lived. Boric, the clearance. Davis was right there on the scene, just slowing Wanderers down, but Gallagher has the ball, breaks wide to the right, still going Sheridan Gallagher, trying to blaze a trail through the penalty box, and she turned it at least into a shot on target. Boric was equal to it.
Yeah, the first clearance there from Boric, a little unconvincing, and fortunately for the Jets, Taryn King was on hand to put a lot of pressure on Gallagher and force a shot that Boric was then able to easily handle.
Galea, and that one was dipping late. Rosie Galea has four A-League Women's goals to her name, all of them pretty spectacular. And that was nearly number five. And so Wanderers are finishing the half the way we hoped, Grace, by looking to press the issue, chasing this equaliser.
Well, Rosie Galea, she is that kind of technical player, and we get another look at this chance here. Taryn King just put some really good defensive pressure on Gallagher, and Boric is able to collect quite easily.
That's a handball, so one last long-range free kick to send forward here. Sonny Franco perhaps wisely just holding everything up so the defence can get set. Wearing the zinc, true to the warm weather games for Sonny Franco. So one last hurrah at the end of the first half. Can Rosie Galea produce what would need to be an exceptional ball? Galea's free kick and rolled away from the area by Eddie into the path of Davis. And now Franco, is there one last hurrah for Newcastle? Bouncing, but not quite towards Brodigan. Casey Reibelt takes a look at the watch and sends this game to halftime. A memorable goal from Tiana Jaber is the difference between the two teams. Western Sydney grew into the game, though, and perhaps their wait for a first goal of the Liberty A-League Women's season won't extend beyond today. 45 minutes to go at halftime. Western Sydney Wanderers 0, Newcastle Jets 1. There is the Centurion, Cass Davis, who has been a bit of a midfield wrecker and one of the reasons that Western Sydney Wanderers still haven't found the back of the net as we kick off the second half at Wanderers Football Park. And with Emily Van Egmond in possession, I welcome Grace Gill back to the commentary booth. And Grace, Wanderers looking better, but they still haven't answered the burning question, which is, can they score a goal?
Yeah, I think they definitely have started better this game compared to their last two. And I think the substitute at halftime, bringing Ashley Crofts on, some fresh legs for Tegan Collister, really sends a message that they're looking to inject a bit of energy into this second 45.
Straight away, the whistle's gone. Caitlin Cooper there, battling against Sonny Franco. Here's Malia Steinmetz. We were discussing off air at halftime, Grace, that because Malia Steinmetz didn't play round one, came off the bench late in round two, does she have 90 minutes in the legs? But she's changed the dimension of that Wanderers midfield, as we expected she would. The real burning question is she a 90-minute player today?
Yeah, and in warm conditions as well, it's going to be a really testing question. I think she's made a huge difference to the Wanderers side in that midfield role. She's been really important.
Jaba, the goal scorer. Best moment of her life. These are the sort of moments that make this competition so much fun to follow. Great interview at halftime as she was walking off the pitch. And well, the job's not done. It might have been the greatest moment of your life, but you've got 45 more minutes to defend. As we see the sub, Crofts trying to make an instant impact, but that little cut across the box is picked up.
Yeah, it was a really lovely interview from Jaba as well, and best moment of your life. It's a big call, but you saw it in her face. It was really special for her, and early opportunity for Ashcroft using her physical presence there to try and get a little ball across the face of the goal, but Borich is able to collect that one quite cleanly.
Claire Coelho on the bench, so fit enough. We were told last week that the reason Borich is in is that Coelho's not 100%. Gallagher does well to win a show of strength against Jaba and now hangs up a very teasing cross. Galea, surely! Oh, it's over the bar and wide, and the eyes lit up, and Rosie Galea knows what a good chance that was.
Well, Rosie Galea, she'll want that one over again. She can finish from that range. She can finish from far. She's such a technician over the ball, and she's just sailed that one over the crossbar. She'll be so disappointed with that effort.
Newcastle defence went to sleep on Rosie Galea there. That's a The finish wasn't what they wanted, but it's a decent sign for Wanderers now that they're swinging the momentum back in their favour again. Van Egmond perhaps on the scene to try and stop all of that. Mate toss, Gallagher, legged. Hannah Brewer is the only player in the game on a yellow card, but just a foul.
I'm sure we'll get another look at this challenge there from Brewer, just coming in through the back of Gallagher there and collecting a little bit too much of her. But this is an incredibly dangerous position for a free kick. And you see Rosie Galea again standing over the top of it as we get another look at this.
So Galea went direct on her left side earlier in the half. Price is there with her for company. Four in the wall, as you can see. And Borich waiting on the line. Galea fluffed her lines just a minute ago with the chance to equalise. Now the chance to take a deep breath. It'll be Price who steps up and takes it instead. And the follow-up is over the bar after rattling the woodwork. Wanderers couldn't get much closer, but they still can't score.
Oh, well, Liv Price, what a strike. She had Georgia Borich beat on the shot, and the follow-up from Briley Henry as well. You think that that's the Wanderers' opportunity. That's their opportunity to equalise and get themselves back in this game.
Well, time's not the enemy just yet, but it's so important that the leaders and the sideline keep the spirit high, because Harding has broken through here. This would be agony for Wanderers, and she was apprehensive with the goal at her mercy. Last-ditch defending saves the day.
Well, that's an incredible defensive effort there from Claire Hunt. That had to be a goal for the Newcastle Jets for Harding there. She had Sarah Langman beat, and it just needed to be a side-footed finish in, but she's just hesitated and propped, and Claire Hunt had not given up on that, and that's a great defensive effort.
Well, as great as it is, I think they're going to have to study the tape as to how they got caught out so badly, Grace. They had Sonny Franco there as well. Harding perfectly entitled to go herself. Van Egmond, slide rule ball. Harding has Franco in the middle. Finds Franco, and Franco scuffed it when the opportunity presented.
Oh, Sonny Franco, that has to be a finish there for the Newcastle Jets. It was a brilliant ball through from Emily Van Egmond and a really nice square in pass from Harding, very selfless. But that has to be a side-footed finish, just walking onto that. It's almost like she's gotten one step ahead of herself and just scuffed it off the side of her foot, but that was surely an opportunity for the Jets to put this one to bed.
They score one. There's no reason they can't harbour ambitions of scoring more, but getting that first one's the issue. Ball into the box. Henry was pushed. Galea with the follow-up. And for the second time in this half, Rosie Galea cannot hit the target free in the penalty area.
Well, there's a shout there from the Wanderers on a foul on Briley Henry, and I think that's a fair call too. Just a little bit too much love in the back there from Lizetti, but Rosie Galea, she'll be so disappointed with that effort. She won't get many more like that this game.
Borich with the bounce, gets to halfway house. The counter is on. Franco, Harding. Flag stays down. It's Harding! It's a good save from Langman. Sophie Harding has had the chances to put this game to bed. And now it's Langman's turn to keep the score at 1-0.
Well, that is a massive save there from Sarah Langman, and what a quality piece of goalkeeping.
Crofts is going to take on Brewer here. Brewer, using all that wily veteran experience, turns away to Javer. And now back to Brewer. And that is cool defending in a crisis. The end-to-end nature of the game continues to deliver chances almost by the minute. And now this one from House sliding through, and Langman, the ball had just enough juice, and that's needless from Sonny Franco. But I think the referee's done the right thing by Wanderers. If you blow the whistle and book her for that, it just wastes time. Instead, the ball has flashed down the other end, and Gallagher has stolen a march on Brewer. Got her ankles tapped, perhaps. Play continues. Galea at the edge of the box. And it bends into the safety of the goalkeeper's grip.
That had some really nice shape on it, that strike there from Galea. It looked like it might just lift, but it's fallen right into the arms of Georgia Borich. But end-to-end stuff at the minute here, Teo. It's just the last couple of minutes are tense times.
We go into the last minute of regulation then. Off the midriff of Hunt, but she brings it under her control. Henry. It sits up. Gallagher. Crofts! Crofts! They've done it! Wanderers are level! And so arrives in the very last minute. It's Ashley Crofts who's done it.
Well, the Western Sydney Wanderers, they've opened their account for the Liberty A-League season, and it's through the substitute Ashley Crofts as well. What a lovely little tap on there from her teammate, and tucked away in the dying minutes of this game. But just end-to-end stuff, and Gallagher's just helped it on, and Crofts beating Georgia Borich on a 6-yard line. What an emphatic finish to this game from the Wanderers.
I don't want this one to end, Race Gill. I want to see a winner. It's coming one way or the other. Galea to Henry. Nods it on. Crofts. Can lightning strike twice? No. Didn't have the power behind the shot. And Borich makes the save. Eddie able to shimmy past. This is it for Newcastle. And another good defensive header from Claire Hunt. She has grown bigger and stronger as the game has gone on, and has stood tall to save Wanderers one last time. We're into the eighth minute of stoppage, and I hate to say it, but we have to end the game. And it finishes 1-1 at the end of an end-to-end action-packed match that may have lacked quality with the finishing in front of goal, but did not lack for entertainment and drama. All over at Wanderers Football Park, Western Sydney Wanderers 1, Newcastle Jets 1.